It's Fran, again, with a quick little vlog about something that I am going to be parting with this week. As you may know, I am a collector of many things, but one of the things in my collection is the only known existing archive of the USS Langley, which was an aircraft carrier in the Second World War in the Pacific. And I came upon these papers, which turned out to be a collection of the on-ship newspaper for the USS Langley, a covered wagon daily news. And it chronicles the tour of the Langley through the war in the Pacific. And it is a one-of-a-kind and certainly priceless. And I have decided to donate it to the Navy. And it's going to be archived in the National History and Heritage Museum in Washington, D.C., where anyone can go to see the Langley papers. And if you go into Washington, you can go to the Naval History Museum, and you can request to see the papers. And hopefully, at least some of these will be available online to look at, because they do contain so many unique pieces of artwork that were done by artists on the ship. And they do chronicle the life of the sailors on the ship. And going through the papers, several things. First, this is the adventures of the Tally-ho Ack-Ack Squadron, or as they refer to themselves, the Tallyackers for short. And the covered wagon is the nickname that the sailors had for the Langley. In fact, it appears on their mission patches as sort of a ship with a covered wagon drawing. And they called it covered wagon because the way it was built. The Langley was originally supposed to be a different kind of ship, so it was sort of built up, and they built the hull up, and then they decided to make it an aircraft carrier, so they just built the aircraft carrier deck like a raised up over top of the regular ship. So from the standpoint of the sailors, it was like having this big covered wagon. And there was a part of the ship they called the tailgate, where they had their sort of recreational times too, which I assume was in the back of the ship, would make sense. But there were several things in here. One thing was that the gunners were called shellbacks. The gunners that operated the anti-aircraft guns to protect the ship from attack from Japanese Zeros, those gunners were called shellbacks. And it's interesting, I could kind of guess why, either that, maybe they were so tough that there was like they had shells on their backs, or maybe they wore some kind of armor, flak armor, to protect themselves from flak or shrapnel while they were at their post, or maybe it was because of the ejected shells from the machine guns that would land on their back or pile around them, maybe. That, maybe there's some interesting reason, but I'm curious to find out why they used the term shellbacks. A lot of the artwork in here, and I have, I talked with the Navy archivist. A lot of the artwork in here is graphic. It's sexually graphic. It's violently graphic, and there are some very harsh depictions of the racial stereotypes that were used for the island natives in the Pacific Island natives, and also the Japanese, of course, which was very commonplace during the war. It is an interesting chronicle in many ways. They do chronicle the battles, the individual battles. There are some handwritten notes in some of these about around the time of the fighting. Another unique word in here was that in the papers they refer to the Japanese Zeros as Zeeks. So that was another little tidbit. They call them Zeeks. So just reading from just one paragraph out of all of these papers, this is from
Cover Wagon Daily News, 3rd, April 3rd, 1944. And the first paragraph is, Tally-ho, ACAC number 45. Our aviators say walleye was a pushover. No opposition, no nothing. So, the scheduled operations are completed. But we are still in enemy waters and within range of enemy aircraft. Rumor says that the portion of the jet fleet, which was at Palau before our arrival, is still running at full speed in the opposite direction. We hope for better luck next time. The Japs cannot avoid a main action surface engagement indefinitely, so it stands this way. If they won't fight, they will lose face. If they decide to fight, they will lose their fleet. And when the time comes, all of us hope to be on deck for the kill. So you can just imagine how this reads page after page, week after week, year after year. It goes all the way through the end of the war. And it's full of a lot of artwork like this. This is Navy Mourns, the Secretary, Frank Knox. Some cheesecake drawings. often, this is probably strategic, but when they have some cheesecake drawings, they also have drawings of like aircraft, enemy aircraft that you should sort of on your toes about. I guess it was sort of no mistake to get your attention. We seek liberty. You name it, $10 reward. We cover USS Langley, the Pacific, September 15th, 1944. So this is one of the smaller papers, and of course a lot of comics, you know, so... Whoop. Censored. We're going to have to censor that one. Like I said, a little raw. Want to keep this PG. and then there's some, you know, maps of activities. You know, this is where they're fighting, where they're, the battles are. There's battle reports. Again, more. Things where they do, you know, cartoons with, you know, descriptions of aircraft. There are a lot of these sort of things, holiday, printouts, Christmas, Christmas Day, again, more. This is from Palau, engagements in Palau. And this one's interesting. It's the personal information booklet handed out on the USS Langley. Basically, you put it in your pocket and it allows you to know where everything on the ship is. Sick bay, armories, offices, engine rooms, machine shops, laundry, you name it. It tells you exactly where to go. The mess hall, all the procedures and such. Pollywogs. The hour of reckoning is at hand. Ye have made your futile gestures. Ye have played with fire. The terrible crimes ye have committed have shaken to the very core our august omnipotent king. Beware, ye slime, the wrath of Neptunus Rex is upon you. Shellbacks, Inc. Shellbacks, Inc. Ooh, it's the Miss Langley. Yep. Like I said, you know, it's kind of a little naive there on the arm, a little bit of, you know, nipplage, but this is interesting, too. Here it says, seek out the enemy, knock him down, then kick his teeth in. Tomp. Like I said, they're being pretty direct. okay. This is the USS Langley, May 21st, 1944. You can see that things have changed. And this booklet, okay, this is The USS Enterprise versus the USS Langley boxing competition. It has a listing of the matches fought, the referees, the judges. After show, sandwiches, cake, and coffee. And it has a program of all the music, jitterbugging, cowboy songs, novelty, which I can only imagine what that is. It has the musical director and all the people there. Yeah, and on the back, Here Comes the Langley. This is the song. Here comes the Langley. Break out the red, white, and blue. Here comes the Langley. Fighting and seagoing crew. Make way for Langley. Langley with anchors away. Everybody loves the Langley of the USA. There you go. Oh, this is May 2nd, 1944. Menu for victory dinner. Cream of tomato soup, crackers, country fried steaks, apple pie a la mode, and you get bread, butter, coffee, cigars, and cigarettes. It says there are 21 Zeeks, that's, 21 zeros, short installations, AKs, and, that's their, and this shows their whole tour crisscrossing through the islands in the Pacific. So, here we go. Death to the Rising Sun. This is kind of graphic. And this one here says, "For that book of memories, remember the night we got the Jap Betty." So, more of those. Description of a German Ju-87 or Stuka bomber. Interesting. So, this is again, this is very graphic, but this is original artwork. Done aboard the ship. And again, more cheesecake on the B-side there, and the Kate torpedo bomber. So they always make sure that if you're looking at the cheesecake, that they also give you an aircraft to study. So, but anyway, that's it goes on and on and on. About 500 pages, maybe 1,000. This is also signed by the captain. This is Christmas 43. And here's the covered wagon. Here's their little symbol for the Langley, right there. The cover wagon. So all this is going to be available for people to look at for research as a historical record of the USS Langley. Crumbly and delicate as it is, they'll preserve it and make sure that it all stays together. A few little pieces here and there falling out, but they'll all go too. So, yeah, there you go.
So these I will be sending out to the Naval Museum this week, and with any luck, you'll all be able to peruse them. And it's quite a large collection. I'm glad that it's going to be preserved and it's going to be accessible to people, because even though this is very, I think it's important to not gloss over the past, the good and the bad. There are things to be learned from collections such as this. One of the things I learned was that, even though I know a lot about the war in the Pacific, I grew up reading about the war and watching a lot of those 70s era documentaries about the war in the Pacific, and of course even the most recent documentary series or the docudrama series that HBO had run about the Pacific. But there are things even beyond those to learn from a first-hand account, because the Langley papers are raw. They're uncensored. They didn't come from Navy brass. They didn't meet any kind of sort of Navy approval. These were written only to be read on the ship, So they're written by the crew members and they're written for crew members. So it is a very honest and uncensored depiction of what life was aboard Navy aircraft carrier in the Second World War. It's a lot to learn. And also, you know, I'm glad that this is going to be back in the hands of the Navy Department because of the add to the rich history of great Navy. So, anyway, that's it. And you know, if you think of it, you can contact the Navy Heritage Museum in Washington, D.C. And I'll post a link in the description. I don't know, you know, when these would be accessible, but any of you that are curious about the Langley papers, go ahead and email the Navy Museum and you can check it out. All right, well, I'm Fran. I'll see you soon. Bye.